on this edition of One Championship Weekly. One Championship starts the year with a bang. One, a new tomorrow in Bangkok, Thailand, features an epic Muay Thai rematch with a world title on the line. You're watching One Championship Weekly. An explosive world championship rematch kicks off the new year in Bangkok. Headlining the night, ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion Rodtang Jitmuangnon faces former ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion Jonathan Haggerty in an incredibly exciting rematch. Rodtang's humble beginnings were paramount in building the legend he is today.
ก็แบบพอโตมาแบบพอมีอายุหน่อยเรียนรู้แบบต้องไปล้างจานกับแม่ตั้งแต่เด็กๆต้องหากินเองก็ครอบครัวใหญ่เป็นอยู่กันแบบอบอุ่นครับก็ไม่ทะเลาะกันครับอยู่กันแบบช่วยเหลือกันใช่ครับพ่อกับแม่พาไปไหนก็ไปเก็บเศษเหล็กก็ไปด้วยกันมีพ่วงข้างก็ไปหาปลาก็ไปกันไปด้วยกันครับดูแลด้วยกันก็ส่วนใหญ่ก็มีแต่พี่น้องๆครับก็ฝั่งข้างบ้านก็มีน้องของพ่อครับก็อยู่กันแบบเขาก็ช่วยเหลือไม่มีอะไรก็เขาช่วยแบ่งบันแบ่งเบามาครับให้กินอะไรทุกอย่าง ถ้าเราจะเดินไปข้างหน้าถ้าเราอยู่อย่างเนี้ยแบบไม่มีอนาคตเตะฝุ่นอยู่ที่บ้านแต่ถ้าเราไปในสายเนี้ยเราก็ได้ทำในสิ่งดีๆแล้วสร้างชื่อเสียงให้กับครอบครัวด้วยอะไรประมาณนี้ครับ
And look at Rodtang say come on here comes Rodtang
ทุกวันนี้มีทุกอย่างก็เพราะมวยไทยครับผมก็จะต่อยมวยเลี้ยงชีพตัวเองไปจนกว่าจนจะหมดแรงครับมันส่งผลไม่ข้อดีไหมครับที่เจออุปสรรคคนเรามันต้องเติบโตด้วยตัวเองครับผมคิดมาเสมอว่าทำไงเราจะเข้มแข็งด้วยตัวเองเติบโตด้วยตัวเองมีทุกอย่างด้วยตัวเองครับ แล้วเราก็เลยแบบเจอทุกอย่างครับก็ต้องผ่านไปได้ผมก็ผ่านเจอมรสุมหลายๆอย่างครับผมก็ผ่านไปได้จนถึงมีทุกวันนี้ได้ครับ
Rodtang proved his Muay Thai superstardom from the very first moment he competed in one super series. Let's take a look at his debut against Lion Fight lightweight world champion Sergio Wielzen. We join the action in round three.
A high right roundhouse kick there from Sergio Wielzen. Backs him up with the left hand and a southpaw start. There's a wild hooking right from Wielzen. He's opened up like a house on fire. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
He's marching forward. There's no fear in his eyes. He's continually pushing forward, challenging Rodtang to throw down with him.
Have you ever seen a walk forward style like Rodtang is showing us tonight? He doesn't take a backward step. He doesn't know how to go in reverse.
Man, you can just see the swagger just oozing out of Rodtang. Just the confidence and belief in himself.
Straight right hand and a short right elbow. Smack bang on the kisser. Gives the beard a shave of Sergio Wielzen. Wielzen now with the knees and Rodtang just ragdolls him and dumps him to the canvas.
Look at him just staring him down, begging him to get up so he can take more of this beating.
Sergio sticks out a stiff jab. That was nicely done. Rodtang goes for the headache maker. There's the uppercut elbow.A wild hook again from Rodtang. He's had more hooks than a pirate's convention. He comes forward again. Overhand right there from Sergio Wielzen. Rides the head kick, comes up with a forearm. Rodtang catching right hand, but only a slip, says referee Onari. No count on Wielzen, picks himself back up. 1:30 remain.
Wilson's continually trying to push forward, but look at this push kick. The timing is beautiful on it. Every single time Wielzen enters that range, boom, the push kick's right there.
Beautifully done from Rodtang. Keeps Wielzen at bay. What has Sergio Wielzen got left in his bag of tricks? This cerebral Muay Thai athlete from the Netherlands. And Rodtang comes forward. Sergio thrust out the left hand. They tango back against the cage. No knees thrown. And referee O'Nally breaks that.
Go, go, go.
Under a minute remaining now. Right hand from Rodtang. They clinch up another dump from the tie. That is Muay Thai 101. And once again, Wilson's got to pick himself up off the floor. Let's see if Rodtang goes back to the liver. Dips the right hand to the bread basket. Forces Wielzen back against the cage. And Wielzen comes forward. What guts, what tenacity here from the multi-world champion Sergio Wielzen. How many shots to the body has he taken from those kicks? There's one to the liver. There's one to the solar plexus. Sergio Wielzen looks spent here. The final 15 seconds of what has been amazing. He swept it. He swept it to the side of the head. It's a second knockdown from Rodtang.
Six, seven.
That left hand has been superb.
You said what makes Rodtang so tough, what makes him so hard to deal with, you said it was his body shots. And that is what is breaking Sergio Wielzen. Look at these push kicks continually going after the body over and over again. And Sergio Wielzen just looks dejected.
Rodtang is a Muay Thai monster.
By unanimous decision from the blue corner, Rodtang
Coming up after the break, two-sport one world champion Stamp Fairtex continues her mixed martial arts campaign. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. Two-sport one world champion Stamp Fairtex continues her mixed martial arts journey in her quest to become the first ever three-sport one world champion. She faces Wushu champion Puja Tomar. No matter the sacrifices and the glory, Stamp knows what's most important, her family.
ก็แรงบันดาลใจหนูมาจากครอบครัวค่ะก็ทุกๆอย่างก็ตอนนี้ก็ทำเพื่อครอบครัวอยู่ค่ะช่วงกลับบ้านคือเป็นช่วงลอยกระทงค่ะก็มีเวลากับครอบครัวมากขึ้นค่ะไปเที่ยวไปไหนด้วยกันมากขึ้นค่ะกลับบ้านก็มีความสุขค่ะเพราะว่านานๆทีเราจะได้กลับบ้านก็ถ้ากลับบ้านมันก็จะมีกิจกรรมเยอะแยะที่เราได้ทำร่วมกับครอบครัวค่ะก็ช่วงกลับบ้านก็จะมีเวลาครอบครัวพาไปวัดหนูจะช่วยพ่อทำสวนค่ะเพราะว่าที่บ้านมีสวนทุเรียนก็จะช่วยพ่อใส่ปุ๋ยบ้างรดน้ำบ้างค่ะก็สำหรับคำว่าครอบครัวของหนูคือความเข้าใจความเอาใจใส่อย่างเช่นพ่อกับแม่หนูก็จะพยายามมาหาทั้งที่แบบไม่มีเวลาก็พยายามเข้ามาว่าเหนื่อยไหมเป็นไงบ้างเขาอยากเข้ามาดูแลเข้ามาเทคแคร์ว่าไม่อยากให้ลูกอยู่คนเดียวรู้ว่าลูกซ้อมหนักแต่ก็อยากมาหาให้กำลังใจค่ะก็ถ้าอยู่นี่ก็กินข้าวคนเดียวบางทีก็คุยกับแม่บ้างแต่ว่าถ้ากลับบ้านมันมีเวลากินข้าวพร้อมหน้าพร้อมตาค่ะถ้าเป็นเมื่อก่อนก็เหมือนแบบธรรมดาเพราะเรายังอยู่บ้านแต่นี่พอออกมามันเหมือนแบบเราต้องการโมเมนต์นี้ที่สุดค่ะ
As the one Atomweight Muay Thai and kickboxing world champion, it's easy to assume that Stamp's skills are based purely on striking. Let's take a look at round three of this incredible action-packed contest.
Bi has been a human sponge at times in this contest, absorbing punishment to then give it back. She just catches that roundhouse kick, nicely deflected there.On the front foot again, Bi Nguyen looks for the left cross down the center corridor.
Circles to her right, which is where she wants to go, away from the right side of Stan Fairtex. You see how Fairtex towers over the killer bee. But Bi always drawing circles with her footwork. Not remaining a stagnant target. You can't be a stagnant target against Stan Fairtex. Fairtex resets. They drift back to center ring. Bi's got to get on the inside. The plyometrics explode in. Work the body. Go to the jaw. Hurt Stan Fairtex. But when you get on the inside, you've got to watch for that vice-like grip. The Muay Thai clinch of the two-sport world champion.
Yep, starting to see what she's got coming at her. Bi Nguyen's mixing up the weapons, going head kicks, spinning back fists on the other side. Not just giving the same looks to Stamp, consistently changing things up. But Stamp's just waiting. She's very patient, but at this point in time, look at Bi Nguyen pushing forward, showing the aggression, starting to touch the champ.
Once again, only 14% of fans have Bi Nguyen for the win. An overwhelming 86% for Stan Fairtex on the one fantasy game of the one super app. Bi Nguyen giving a very good account of herself. She said she had the tools to defeat Stan Fairtex, to derail the hype of Stan Fairtex. Stamp has not attempted to take Bi to ground. Bi Nguyen taking her time, trying to find a chink in the armor, trying to find even a minute opening. A little crouched on the guard here, Stan Fairtex. Gloves up high. Will she explode in and work those knees, work those elbows? Bi staying on the outside, but there'll come a time when she needs to get on the inside. And with 2 minutes 15 to go, that time is, well, right about now. High right roundhouse kick there from Stan Fairtex. Bi backs her off with the left hand, making the power hand of the southpaw. Bodies then head, changing levels, good outside leg kick. Counter right hand there from Stan Fairtex, knocked the head back. High left roundhouse from Bi Nguyen. Here comes Stan, heels the right hand to the jaw. Bi Nguyen does a quick counter motif.
Right hand is starting to touch the chin of Nguyen. Almost both of the counters are like three beautiful counter right hands that Nguyen was able to, Stamp was able to land.
There are a lot of people who thought that Stan Fairtex would light up Bi Nguyen. She thought she'd put Nguyen out in 2 rounds. It hasn't been the case. Bi Nguyen still here. And she's landing on Stan Fairtex. So too Fairtex on Nguyen. 1 minute and 15 seconds remains in what has been a gripping contest. Silence inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Everyone on the edge of their seats for this one. There are so many ramifications for the result here. You know that in Hawaii, the world champion Angela Lee is watching this one on BR Live. Keeping a close eye on perhaps a future opponent, a future challenger for Angela's gold. 45 seconds remains now. Fairtex edges forward. Does Bi put the foot down? Does she pull out all the stops, throw caution to the proverbial wind now, and try and go after Stamp's jaw? Don't forget our 3 judges are not scoring this one round by round. They are scoring it as an overall contest. 20 seconds now. Is there one big tub thumper left for one of these 2 women? 2 extraordinary athletes. They've given it their all. Bi lunges forward with her right hand. Final 10 seconds now. Stan Fairtex clinching knee, misses the target. Bi goes high with the left roundhouse kick. And look at the integrity, the honor.
Bi unanimous decision from the red corner, Stan Fairtex.
After the break, Wushu champion Puja Tomar is proud to carry the Indian flag against two-sport one world champion, Stan Fairtex. You're watching ONE Championship Weekly. Welcome back to ONE Championship Weekly. Wushu champion Puja Tomar faces the toughest challenge of her career in two-sport ONE World Champion Stamp Fairtex. Mixed martial arts is on a meteoric rise in India, and Tomar is proud to be leading the way for Indian martial arts.
India ko represent karte hain. Aisa lagta hai ki haan, jo chahiye tha, main us abhi wahan pe hoon main.
Crown, no chains, no rings to keep me down.
जब भी मैं जैसे वुशु खेलती हूँ अपना या तो कोई ना कोई उसमें से जो खेलता है वो मुझे जानता है और फिर बोलता है कि आप पूजा तोमर हो तो मुझे वो चीज़ सुन के बड़ा अच्छा लगता है कि हाँ मार्शल आर्ट को जान रहे हैं एमएमए को इंडिया में इतना मिल रहा है. थोड़ा मुश्किल लगता था कि जब मैं पहले स्टार्टिंग में खेलती थी कि शायद इंडिया में एमएमए को कोई इतना पहचान नहीं दे पाएगा, लेकिन अभी मैं देख रही हूँ कि हमारे थोड़ा थोड़ा बॉलीवुड में भी एमएमए आ रहा है और इंडियन गवर्नमेंट के दिमाग में भी कहीं ना कहीं थोड़ा सा एमएमए आ रहा है कि सच में है कुछ एमएमए. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इन फ्यूचर अगर एमएमए का अच्छा इवेंट होता है तो कहीं ना कहीं क्रिकेट लेवल तक तो एमएमए जा सकता है. वन चैम्पियनशिप में हाँ तो उसमें जैसे कि हमारे इंडिया से रितु फोगाट है, उनका काफ़ी नाम है फोगाट फैमिली का यहाँ से, तो अभी उन्होंने जैसे रिप्रेजेंट किया है तो काफ़ी लोगों के दिमाग में आ रहा है कि हाँ वन चैम्पियनशिप है एमएमए है, तो यहाँ पे भी काफ़ी लोग एक्साइटेड है. सब कहते हैं कि हमें वन कोई ये नहीं कहता है एमएमए खेलना है, सब कहते हैं वन चैम्पियनशिप खेलना है.
The multi-time Indian national wushu champion, who was known at the start of her career for her lightning-fast knockouts, says she wants to bring the lightning back into the cage.
जब मुझे वन चैम्पियनशिप से ऑफर आया, उसके बाद मैंने सोचा कि बस अब मुझे एमएमए करना है. उससे पहले तो सिर्फ ये था कि मेरे घर की सिचुएशन ठीक नहीं है, मुझे थोड़ा पैसे मिल जाएंगे, थोड़ा सहारा हो जाएगा. लेकिन उसके बाद ऐसा लगा जैसे वन चैम्पियनशिप का पहला इवेंट देखा, इतने लोग देखे मैंने फर्स्ट टाइम, और मैंने देखा कि ये भी एक दुनिया है, यहाँ पे भी मैं अपना नाम बहुत बड़ा कर सकती हूँ अगर मैं बहुत ज़्यादा मेहनत करूँगी. और इंडिया में भी पहले से अब बहुत ज़्यादा रेस्पेक्ट मिलने लगी है. लेकिन कभी कभी ऐसा होता है जब हम हार जाते हैं थोड़ा डिसरेस्पेक्ट निगेटिव वर्ड्स भी होते हैं, लेकिन बहुत अच्छा लगता है जब तो मैंने कभी उस चीज़ को निगेटिव वे में नहीं लिया. हमेशा जो भी कुछ किसी ने बोला मैंने हमेशा पॉजिटिव वे में लेके और अपनी ट्रेनिंग की. जैसे कि काफ़ी जूनियर्स है या जहाँ अकेडमी में जाती हूँ छोटी मोटी में, तो वो छोटी अकेडमी में जाती हूँ लेकिन वहाँ मेरी फ़ोटो लगी रहती है, मुझे बड़ी खुशी होती है देख के. मैंने कहा अरे ये तो मैं हूँ शायद, तो ऐसा लगता है कि हाँ मैं ग्रो कर रही हूँ अपनी लाइफ में. मैं बाहर जाती हूँ और जब मेरी एंट्री होती है पूजा तोमर फ्रॉम इंडिया, तो तभी ऐसे लगता है कि सच में मैं जहाँ चाहती थी मैं वहाँ पर खड़ी हूँ और मुझे बहुत ऊपर जाना है.
At the start of 2019, Tomar faced the always exciting Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongao in an action-packed competition. Let's join the match in round three.
Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongao's got to shift gears on this and level up.
Puja Tomar has come out here tonight to show the watching world that she is not cannon fodder. Just missed with the counter, here we go, boom, shakalaka! And the crowd loves it in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar's got an arm in guillotine, crank it on the neck. Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongao's gonna pick her back up.
Pops the head out, does Priscilla. They are raising the roof in Jakarta for Priscilla Hurtado Lumbongao.
Oh, look at Priscilla dropping down to attack the leg. Looks like she's going for a Boston crab here, Michael.
Trying to employ her inner Rick Martel. Top position for Priscilla Hertati Lumbango. Close guard from Toma. Can she posture up here, Priscilla? And the chance go up again. Listen to this. Absolutely crazy scenes of pandemonium inside the Astora Senayan in Jakarta.
Puja Tomar has still got the guard. She's got to try to attack. She's just trying to keep the head nice and close, or possibly hoping for a stand-up. But you can see that Priscilla's being just active enough to delay that possible stand-up. She has, she's patting the head, a little bit of activity. Tomar's got to push away and stand back up.
Priscilla hasn't won by submission since February last year. A scarf hold arm lock, I should say, against Rome Trinidad. That was in May of last year. She guillotine choked Rome. Before that was a scarf hold arm lock against Crystal Embarga. Looking for a downward elbow there in the ground and pound, and Puja closes that guard, tries to keep it tight. She doesn't want those hands, those elbows raining down on her face.
Tomar's not being very active in her guard. She's at least got to start creating a little bit of space so she can throw some elbows to do a little bit of damage on this. You can see, just because you're on top does not necessarily mean you're winning, especially in our scoring. So she's got to be a little bit more active from the bottom. She's got to create space, she's got to attack, she's got to try to advance her position. You can see Priscilla's just touching her up. She's not really doing anything. She's not really creating any damage on this.
1 minute 40 remained. Third and final round. Priscilla trying to break open that guard of the Indian. Crazy scenes, glow sticks are waving, everybody's chanting, they're out of their seats inside the sold-out Istora Senayan.
Puja's got to be a little bit more active here. She's got to create some separation. Right now, she's just holding on to the head. I think she believes she's too far ahead so far, so she's not trying to create any movement. I'd like to see her open her guard, get her butterfly hooks in, because you can see how much forward pressure, how far she's leaning over, but she's sweeping her. Oh, gives up her back in the process, Michael.
Oh, Priscilla has the back. Is this the beginning of the end?
Oh, this would be magnificent if
they're gonna go nuts if she taps it. They're gonna go crazy if she taps it.
Tomar's tough. She's hanging in there. That's close.
Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Priscilla wants to choke her out, wants to put her to sleep.
Tomar's got to pull the hands off her head. She's got to peel those hands off.
25 seconds on the clock. She's going to soften her up a little more now.
Punching her way home. 18 seconds. Tomar's still in it.
Unrelenting with the left hand. And Tomar tries to defend against those punches. Final 10 seconds. Can she choke her? It's more of a face crank.
By split decision from the blue corner, Puja
with an outstanding year behind it, one championship looks to 2020 for another historic year. It begins with one, a new tomorrow in Bangkok, Thailand on the 10th of January. An epic world title rematch headlines the night as one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, defends his belt against the man he originally claimed it from, former one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Jonathan Haggerty. And two sport one world champion, Stamp Fairtex, continues her mixed martial arts quest as she faces Indian Wushu champion, Puja Tomar. Check your local listing. Thank you for watching One Championship Weekly.